Hey everyone, this is Zach, and welcome to this beginner tutorial on PreSonus Studio One Pro, one of the best DAWs for creating songs or compositions on Windows and macOS. In just a few minutes, we will cover all the basics you need to know to start from scratch. When you open Studio One, the Start page appears. On the left, you get your most recent projects, and on the center, you can configure your audio devices and drivers, as well as connecting any external instruments you have. Click on New at the top to start a new project, selecting the right template. Choose Record and Mix to create an independent song by combining audio samples and compositions. Master and release if you're making a collection of songs, such as an album or a playlist. Rehearse and perform, or launch loops to arrange MIDI files and samples for live performances. For the purpose of this tutorial, let's create a new song, defining name, location, and options, such as sample rate, bit resolution, time base, and maximum song length. As you click on OK, the main song workspace opens. You get the main timeline at the center, several editing tools above it, and on the right, several panels we are going to see. From the top right corner, you can come back to the Start page, or click on Documents to switch between projects you're currently working on. The timeline is the main place where you edit, arrange, and compose your song. You can drag and drop audio files like MP3, WAV, or FLAC from your folders or from the browser panel on the right, under the File section. These samples are shown on the timeline with their waveforms and time and file name within colored blocks called events. These events also match the color of the corresponding row or audio track. You can zoom in and out vertically by holding down the Control or Command key while using your mouse wheel, or horizontally in time with Control Shift or Command Shift. To play the timeline content, click above to place the playhead and use either the spacebar key or the player at the bottom. The time placement is displayed at the bottom, either in bars or in seconds. You can also change the timeline format from time base above. Now, let's see how to record with your microphone. Right-click on the left and create a new audio track. If your microphone is on and connected, it appears in the Input Sources list, where you can select between stereo and mono. At this point, arm the track and check if the volume meter reacts to the microphone. Then, start and stop the recording by clicking the record button at the bottom. The recording will ignore the output from other tracks in playback. If your microphone is not showing, go to the Studio One tab, then to Options, Audio Setup. Click on Control Panel and verify if your microphone is detected, and also select it as Main Recording Device in bold. Enable the arrow tool at the top to edit and manage the events on the timeline. Click on an event near its bottom edge to select it and drag it to move it in time or to another track. Move the central node to adjust the event volume uniformly, with the Shift key down for more precision. This is very useful if the event volume is too high, shown by a volume meter in red color on the left. Drag from the event corners to create transitions, increasing or decreasing its volume and time. You can also refine the transition envelope with its central node. Right-click on an event to duplicate it, reverse its audio, or go to Transpose to edit its pitch by adding or subtracting semitones. You can also cut, copy, paste, or remove the event entirely. You can also cut and copy parts of an event by clicking and dragging on it. undo any action with Control or Command and Z, or through the History window from the Edit tab. To split an event, select it, place the playhead in time, and press Alt or Option key and X. To trim an event, drag from its edges properly. You can also hold down Alt or the Option key while dragging edges to change the playback speed of the event. For example, if you shorten an event, this will be played faster. On the left side, you get all the track options. Use the M button to mute a track, or the S button to solo it, muting all the other tracks. Adjust the track volume by dragging the horizontal bar and right-click on it to remove or duplicate the track. From Expand Envelopes, you can also realize automations in order to edit properties like track volume and stereo panning over time. Use the arrow tool to add points and shape the envelope. Or the paint tool to draw the envelope freehand. Enable the eraser tool to remove points if you need. You can turn off or on any automation by clicking on the I/O button. Now, let's see how to make MIDI compositions. These are very useful to create melodies, drum patterns, and percussion sequences completely from scratch. On the left, right-click to add a new instrument or MIDI track. Then, drag any MIDI file you have, or double-click on the track to drop an empty MIDI event to start with. This MIDI track has no sound until you add an instrument, with either a virtual synthesizer or synth within the software, or an external instrument connected that you record while playing. For this beginner tutorial, we will compose with virtual synth only. Open the Browse panel on the Instrument section and drag any synth onto the MIDI track. This synth becomes part of the song as a new input source, already selected for the MIDI track chosen. At this point, you can click on the piano icon to open the synthesizer interface and edit its properties. To start composing, open the Edit panel from the bottom right corner. This shows three views: the piano view for melodies and notes, the drum view for percussions, or the score view if you prefer the traditional notation. When using the piano or the drum view, enable the Paint tool and click and drag to drop notes with proper length. Click on any note to remove it quickly. With the arrow tool, you can select notes to adjust their position and length. At the bottom, set the properties for each note, such as velocity and pitch. While composing, it can be helpful to play the MIDI event in loop. Just click and drag above the timeline to create a loop region, which will appear on the Edit panel and the main timeline. Once done, enable the Loop Active button at the bottom and play the event continuously. At the bottom, you get several settings for your entire song. Under Timing, adjust the time signature and beats per bar. The Transpose option lets you shift the pitch of all the tracks that have the Global Transpose option enabled from the Inspector panel. You can also adjust the tempo, measured in BPM or beats per minute, to set the project speed. In particular, for all MIDI tracks on a beats time base, MIDI tracks on seconds time base or rendered audio samples are not affected by the tempo. MIDI events and MIDI tracks can be managed as seen for audio samples. You can move and edit MIDI events in the same manner, and also render them into samples by dragging these onto an audio track. On the left, MIDI tracks have the same options of audio tracks, including automations that can be added by right-clicking on any synth property. Open the Mix panel to manage all your tracks together. On the center, you get all the tracks represented as vertical columns or channels. And on the right, you have the main track, or master channel, which collects the output of your entire song. Each track comes with several options that you can hide and show from the left side of the panel. You get the volume meter in decibels, with a vertical slider to adjust volume, and a horizontal one for panning. You also get the mute and the solo buttons, and the input and output sources above. For example, a MIDI track shows the synth as input source, while the main channel as its output source. These track options are similar to the ones you can find in the Inspector panel as well. You can also add audio effects to your tracks. Open the Effects section of the browser window and browse for the complete list of VST, VST3, and AU plugins available. Then, drag and drop any effect onto an entire audio or a MIDI track that gets listed in the Insert section of the corresponding channel on the Mix panel. You can enable or disable any effect with the I/O button, and right-click to edit the effect properties or remove it from the list. You can also rearrange the effect's order by clicking and dragging any. Save your song project quickly with Control or Command and S. To render it into an audio file, go to Song, Export Mixdown, specify the file name and location, and choose the file format, bit resolution, and sample rate at the bottom. You can also decide what to export, such as the current loop region with between loop, or the entire song with song start end marker. And there you have it. That's all you need to know to get started with Studio One Pro. Don't forget to check out our YouTube channel and our official website for more tips, resources, and videos on music production and DAWs.